It's the
I did take one Hydro Blast out for a second copy of Force Negation. There's so much fucking oops all spells in the Modo leagues. So I just wanted one more free counter. I almost put it in the main deck. I actually picked up a Minskin Boo. They're like 80 ticks on Modo. I scooped one for this league. I almost replaced it with a Force Negation. I was like, $80 though. I can always resell it. Anyway, I'm excited to jam some games. I've been playing a lot of three-color control. This is going to be my first time playing the four-color with Reb's version. Hey, 3 land, 7 mana. Thanks for the 23 months there. Blasted Man says, I don't mean this to be insulting, but I remind you of Shrek in human form. Yeah, who would be insulted by that? Shrek gets way more tail than I do. I'm like fucking first movie Shrek. Living alone in a swamp, getting mad at donkeys. It's not good. It's not good. Hell yeah, I love control. Just getting things kicking off here. Play some Legacy. Haven't played Legacy in a little bit. I'm excited. They did BR Wrath, yeah. Yeah, I played with Minsk and Boo a little bit in the Arena Cube. Haven't gotten to fuck with it in Legacy yet. Many months! Hey, Jade Cabby, thanks for 59 months there. You wanna shove the robots in? What are the robots? I mean, this deck could just play DAC and some Punishing Fires. Wouldn't be hard. DAC and Uro play really well together. You'd just be like splitting DACs with Narsets or something. Pretty good with Narset. What's the difference between Hydro and Pyroblast and Reb and Blue Elemental Ballast? The main difference is you can cast Pyroblast even if it's not blue. So say you've got an Uro in your graveyard, right? And there's fucking four other cards in your graveyard, and you have five mana. You can Pyroblast targeting something that's not blue, like target your own fucking land. And then you can bring Uro back. Whereas Red Elemental Blast and Blue Elemental Blast, the card needs to be blue to be a legal target. So they're worse. They're a little worse. And that's why Pyroblast is like a $12 card, and why Red Elemental Blast is like a $4 card on Modo. And that's why I don't own four Pyroblasts. I just have three of that card. Hey, Cheese, thanks for the 28 months there. Must be some sort of mistake. You don't remember subbing to this baby-faced child? I remember you subbing. Just like it was just a few seconds ago. Hey, CMFP, thanks for 51 months there. Rev is great against redirect spells. Yeah, that's like an EDH thing, right? That's not a Legacy thing. I haven't seen a misdirection cast in fucking years. Hell yeah, Labrador. Oh, shoot, what up? Hey, Blue Srag, thanks for the sub, thanks for 5 months. This driver is out for blood. Hey, we got an opponent. We revealed a companion. Our hand seems reasonable. This Pluto Delta's got some fucking work to do, huh? This Pluto Delta's got a lot of work to do. Simply fetch the 4-mana card. We'll land the depths for 4 different colors, and we'll be okay. Yeah, this song rules. Whole album's good, but this is definitely the most hyped track. Showing up. Hey, Silent Chibi. Thanks for the sub. Thanks for 13 months. We weren't expecting to get jump scared, but no beard Caleb. Waste Lightning there might have been wrong. I maybe should have saved it to pay for days on Brainstorm. Like, that's a fucking jump scare. More like, bah! Now that's a jump scare. Hey, Wamp01, thanks for giving a sub to Paladin Yeegan. Congrats, Paladin. Are we forcing a pyroblast? Is that what it's come to? Possibly should have VOT brainstormed. Nowadays? Sure. Fair enough. And that's kind of what I was thinking, like, I maybe shouldn't have wastelanded. Just because it prevented me from being able to pay for days on a cantrip. That was poor on my part. I was forcing there to try and resolve the Ponder in case they had Wasteland. Just like shut me out of the game, you know? Yeah, that's fine. Force pitching expressive. Okay. We are, Madman. That's exactly what we're trying. So far, I've been playing it worse than how he'd be playing it. Shaking some rust off. Been a bit since I played some Legacy. Try to play the tag out to play around dazed. I can't really afford to get dazed again. It's so miserable to play your land, your non-fetch pre-brainstorm, but I don't think we want to shuffle anyway, right? We want to leave this Terminus on top. Dang it. Dang. Legacy sucks. I haven't played in a while, and here we're just like multiple main deck pyroblasting each other back and forth. This format might be bad, folks. I think one main deck pyroblast can be like in a healthy format. I think when everybody's main decking multiple, like we've got three in this deck, and now our Murktide opponent is also playing multiple. I don't know. I don't know. This format might suck. Don't play those decks? Yeah. I mean, I'm going to play some Mono Black later, but I think we might just be losing to Expressive Iterations and Minsk and Booze and Uros and stuff. We'll see. Yep. Yep. Hey, a Polish sniper. Thinks the 58 months there. How goes it? It's okay. It's okay. Yeah, I saved the file earlier. I just forgot to upload it to Stream Decker. And there we go. It's updated now. Cool. Good stuff.
Oh, shit. What up?
So much carpeting. Hey, the other Shaco 30 thinks the 39 months there. Almost an even number, yeah. It feels like even numbers show up just about as often as odd numbers. It's interesting. Looking tidy, thank you. Yeah, this wasn't actually from shaving, just a friction. Your mother says hi. I'm sorry. That was uncalled for. You were being nice. You were being kind.
Oh shit, what up?
And I had to bring mothers into it. Hey, Lord of Depression. Thanks for 47 months there. Appreciate you.
Hi, Mom.
Yeah. What the last cut's supposed to be? In this matchup, it's definitely not any of these. Could be a Narset or a Minsk or something. We had multiple Minsk rotting in hand there. I don't know if I'm supposed to like Terminus here. Probably not. I have so many fucking Rebs and Hydro Blasts and shit. Well, even one. What happened to my face? I told you, I just said friction.
Oh shit, what up?
Oh shit, what up? Hey, Big Oofta, thanks for gifting two subs. Congratulations to PH43 and Benabzongo. Congrats, folks. Thanks, Big Oofta. Yeah, cheers. I think cutting the fourth Narset is wrong, but. Gotta cut something, huh? Hey, multiple land drops. Yeah, this feels way better. Why is this Planeswalker good? Murders people, draws cards. Unlike Jace, it doesn't get fucking pyroblasted. I'm gonna pyroblast here. If they want to daze me, that's totally fine. Expressive, but nothing to Uro. you just, like, don't care if Uro gets countered at all most of the time. And we even have the land all set up. Yeah, I've been countered. Got me. You missed a fucking party last night, and that's what you missed, Speg. You missed a wild fucking time. We need a blast for every color. Yeah, and apparently they should all counter blue cards. Just every single one. How much better would black be in Legacy if Pyroblast was a black card?
But Kayla, what about the color pie?
Fuck the color pie! You heard me. I have been dazed. I'm assuming we untap with all of our lands here, and next turn I think we lead on Expressive, play Sylvan out. We'll see what they do. Is Murky coming? Murky showing up? Hey, congratulations, the Nun. I bet it's fucking magnificent. Doing. Yeah, ideally the Expressive would resolve there because we're digging for an answer to this Murktide like now, right? And ideally you don't want to take seven. And then have it just be like a lethal attack in the next hit. Is a concern? Is that a consideration? I'm wondering if we should express it first to try and bait out a force of will. But they might just not have forces post-board. If I wasn't going to play the expressive this turn, then I probably should have gotten paid for the land instead of the expressive so I could go swords into Minsk. That would have been better. Hey, you dude, thanks for the 75 months there. 3/4 of the way there. We're there! Yeah! Long pause in my draw steps, interesting. Waiting for Falco Lombardi. Now, I think I'm supposed to lead on Expressive. It's an outside chance. They would use a hard counter on it if they had Force. And if it resolves, it could find, like, a Pyroblast to protect the swords, right? If their last two cards were Bolt post-board, that would be something. Mental misstep? God. That's like one of the only ways they could make this worse. Man, mental misstep for the fucking Reb format. Waiting for Falco. I feel these emotions building up inside. I don't know what to do. Always touching on touch screens. Just want to see. Maybe this could be real. Yeah, you're probably right, Eisenberg. Especially with me paying four for Sylvan. This is a matter of sequencing, right? Like, what is it, what's better? You're not thinking, like, what is likely. You're thinking, like, when you're thinking of which is better to lead on, you gotta think about all the different random fucking scenarios. Even if they're sitting on a Pyroblast, if their hand is, like, fucking Pyroblast, Brainstorm, and you lead on Expression, they might just fire it off. Whereas if you lead on Swords, then maybe they brainstorm and find Force of Will blue card. Shit like that. Would have been insane if they'd spell pierced me there. Uh-oh. Oh, I could have fucking... Well, you have one card. It's like kind of worth to shock to Uro, too. It wouldn't be worth to put myself to play Minskin Boo, but Uro gains the 3 life back immediately. A little bit better, huh? I think Simply Cabbage. Is this another Murktide? Races the Murktide because this one's just a 3/3. Yeah. Still didn't cast this Minskin Boo card. Why they concede? Because Uro beats their 3/3, is why. We had Sylvan Library going. They were dead, is the concession reason. I changed one card, Zachary. It's his list. Literally just threw another Force Negation in the board. I feel like Oops All Spells is, like, overrepresented in the Modo Leagues. It's always, like, up the force count. Because losing to that deck is embarrassing. Yep. We're gonna wait at least a turn to swords here. I actually like swords and gun too, because even if we're like we lose the counter battle over it, we can just slam a row on three. Yeah, in larger events, I think there's like more blue-red. It's a little bit more inbred of a meta, and you can get away with playing. Playing fewer Force of Wills and shit. Or Forces in general. Obviously, still playing for Force Will. Anyway. Oh, the Kaya Hydro Blast, right? Empire Blast. Really cool. Really fun. Force of Wills, Daiko. It's a name. If you had two of me, would I be two Calebs Durward, or would I be two Caleb Durwards? I got a print of the Phil Foglio Presence of the Master art. And then I lost it. I went to like go frame all my shit and it's gone. And I think it got thrown out. I think past Caleb when he was drunkenly cleaning. Thought it was an empty tube. I'm very sad about it. I've like searched my house several times. Anyway. Fucking past Caleb, fucking it up again.
Oh shit, what up?
Hey, Dan's Man 9, this is 21 months there. We did have this conversation yesterday, Return to Jang. And we'll have it tomorrow and the day after. That's just my life. Nothing's original. Everything's the same. It's just the cycle of life. It's like way less likely to get countered on three. We could just bring a row back. What up? Hey, Wiznerd. Thanks for 29 months there. Ending on 4, and then you start running into soft counters, White Seal. I think 3 is the ideal number there.
Oh, shit. What up?
Like, if you do it on 3, and they yeah, whatever. Maybe rebind the swords is better than rebind the blast. I'm not sure. Hey, good night, Nururu. Thanks for the 22 months there. Buying Hydro Blast here is wrong too. It probably is. Because I can't have it up for expressive. And they're like out of Pyro Blasts. Well, they probably have like one or two more, but. I think they were about to play out a DRC. And they're like, wait a minute. I like that these aren't lands, but I think I shuffle this. Hey, much better.
Hi.
Hello.
How are you? I'm glad to hear that. If I may take a moment of your time, I'd like to take this opportunity to tell you about something so new, so revolutionary, so exciting.
I'm listening.
That it will completely change your life.
Ooh.
Now I know what you're thinking. Trust me, I get it. So I'm gonna cut right to the chase. If you respect high quality,
yeah, but then I'm down a card, Lord of Depression. If I want a Hydro Blast to land or whatever, then I'm down a card. Whereas if they play out a red thing for me to target, and we're trading evenly. One Murky Boy. Expressive pre-combat, so I can get an Uro attack in if I hit an answer, but I think I want to go to my second main phase. Use this for red. Just get more churn. Shrines, like the resell, these are 16 months. Shrine's saying, got any grapes? Treaty R with the resub with 30 months, saying much love. Much love to you, Treaty R. And Quickstar 09, thanks for the resub, thanks for 20 months there. Three expressives, three subs. Coincidence? Yes, yes, almost assuredly a coincidence, but still very neat. Why did I shave? I didn't. No, these are friction burns, Kino Wolf. I felt like losing some weight and I didn't want to diet. And I'm out of Mystic Sanctuaries to rebuy Pyroblast. So might need some help from Narset here. Actually, Uro can just fucking serve into that, huh? At least I have a Hydro Blast. I do have a Hydro Blast, yeah. Oh shit, what up? Hey, Rockslide Jr., at least the 28 months there. So many months. Exactly, you dude. Yeah, you got it. Num 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 num. Like fucking Boss Nass from the prequel movies. He gets all slobbery. Nice fluffy face. I guess. Yeah, I feel like going Boss Nass on that booty should be an expression. And it is! I just made it! Turn one Triome? What are you hiding? Getting Boss Nasty. Love it. Love it.
Oh shit, what up?
Hey, Right Nut. Thanks for the 6 months, the half a year. Legacy and TWRP, your favorite things? Nice. I like your tastes, Right Nut. I wonder if there's like a show and tell thing. If I should hold on to this Caracas. Ketria Triome? Who the fuck's playing Ketria Triome?
Oh shit, what up?
Hey, Funkified, thanks for 54 months there. You don't know who this beardless imposter is? But I guess they can have my sub. Well, that's good. It's good to know that if someone ever, like, murdered me and stole my skin and my identity, people would be like, yeah, it's fine. Here, you have my sub, whatever. You're here. It'd be a shame if this Prime sub went to waste, you know? You can't just waste this shit. Yeah, I want to get a red source down. So next turn I can expressive before playing my land. The sub will be well deserved. Yeah, I guess it's a lot of work to make a Caleb suit. Speaking of human skin suits, how about the how about that first Men in Black movie, huh? The Edgar suit? Obviously he had a little bit of makeup, but like there weren't prosthetics and stuff for his part there, and that was just like all his acting. His weird jerky walk. So good. You love how it deteriorated through the movie? Yeah, really strong. Should I be swordsing this? I kind of hate swordsing it with the trigger on the stack, because we can swords it later. I feel like you swords this and then just like play another one. And then like get to keep the graveyard value. We have Caracas to like kind of control the Euro battle. Kind of. Hello, Sylvan. Wow, I'm actually not going to be paying 8. I don't know if I pay any here. I should have played out Caracas in case they felt like swordsing me and that protection. I think I should have, yeah. Caleb, you fool! I like literally just did it to them and now I'm getting got for no reason. Just wasn't thinking. Should I sheepishly put the Caracas into play? Forest? Nah. Now we have 3 more Uros in here. You don't want to force over that, I don't think. Not pitching an iteration. Iteration's so good. You don't want to make like another mistake trying to make up for your first one. No! That sucks. That sucks real hard. The issue with forcing here is, like, what if they have force, right? What if they force back? Whereas you could draw a blue card for turn, fire off expressive. If they felt like doing a counter battle, then you could force back. Or, like, maybe they don't even counter expressive. We really need more cards is the issue. We also have Mystical to get back expressive. I think we just let this happen. It's really uncomfy. I wanted more out of that Sylvan, but... Hey, sup? Sup, Earl? Okay, I'm gonna play my Caracas first this time. But why? They don't have white up. I also can't Uro and rebuy it. Because the Delta can't find me a Taiga. That's my third green source. Let's play it anyway. Yeah, that was good. So I'm just sitting here chilling with my Force of Will. They swords my Uro, I don't force. They prismatic ending my Sylvan Library, I don't force. rip Uro, play it, draw another Sylvan Library, and just like, yeah, your turn. Oh, man. Here they are again! The same things that you just answered. Ooh, field could be an issue. We need to find loam for our wasteland. We need to make sure not to wasteland, or to exile wasteland to Uro. We in a loop? Not quite yet, no. We might literally be looping expressive in a few turns. Every day is Groundhog Day, yeah. We force that one, though. I feel like still no. What they pitch? They pitch their own Uro? Oh, because I've got Caracas, I see. Sure. I want the Pluto Delta so I can get Expressive back this turn, but the Tiger would let me hardcast Endurance. Maybe that's better. Just start attacking. I'm pretty sure I want Expressive next turn. I guess I could crack fetch next turn and then ponder into it. That seems so much worse though. I'd like to save the ponder to pitch the forest. They play Endurance, so I'm doing this so that they can't just go like go second green source from hand and hardcast Endurance in response to the Sanctuary fetch. Tiger could grab Scalding. It's a matter of like, what do I want to do this turn though? Yeah, we wanted to play one of those lands off the Expressive, for sure. Is this a common shell? This is Anzid's list. And he took down some online tournament with it recently, so I guess it depends on what you mean by common. Fairly newer because Minsk and Boo just got added on the modo recently. Huh. Yeah, the one downside of Mincing Boo is that when it comes into play, it has that trigger. So if the opponent has a bolt, they can kill it immediately with Lightning Bolt. But after that, you know, not an issue. That's certainly not an issue in this matchup. I might be putting Yori into hand soon. I like the idea of getting the Narset down. Leaf of Crocus to protect the hamster. What was I thinking? This is like fine, right? I think this is fine. Oh, they only have one card left. We had you counter it. The thing is, they down tick it, and Mince just like serves at it. I think this is totally fine. Yeah, they agree. The recommended amount of blue cards for Force of Will? It depends on your deck. It depends on how consistently you need the Force, how likely you are to hard cast it. Whether just like casting Force of Will is fine, or whether you want options for pitching. Like, if you're playing Force of Will, and like one of the blue cards that you're counting, like you need to literally win the game, then it's hard to count it for Force of Will, because you're like, you're never going to want to pitch it, right? So there's a ton of different factors, but in general, like 18 is like the hard minimum, and usually you want to be up in the low 20s at least for Force of Will, if you want to have options. I wrote an article about it back in the day, and I used examples for like different extremes. I had a painter list that would like went all the way down to like 14 blue cards for Force, but it was very consistent at getting painter into play, and then you would just like pitch the other cards. So who cares? And a lot of the colorless cards were good at getting blue cards in your hand, like top and stuff. So it was a lot more consistent than it looked. But again, that's an extreme case, huh? I guess we're carpeting again. Actually, did they show me red cards? I feel like they were just like banned stuff, right? Probably don't actually want Hydro Blast. They're not doing. Giving some number of Prismatics in for Sylvan Library. Opposing Sylvan Libraries and Narsets and stuff. Actually, Prismatic might just be better than Swords. Does Yorion factor into blue cards for Forest? It can. Usually not. So, like, I have yet to put it into my hand with this deck. And, in Legacy, you really want your Force of Wills to be active before turn 3 in a lot of matchups, right? Like, if you're facing Oops All Spell, like, there's no way you live to turn 3 to put the Ori into hand to pitch to Force of Will, right? Leyline Binding versus Prismatic Ending. Well, Prismatic being able to answer like Aether Vial on turn one is pretty huge, right? Pretty big. And there's stuff that can blow up Leyline Binding in this format, get their shit back. Could come up. Instant Speed could be good versus like Dark Depths, I guess. Yeah, Pyroblast is better at Colic, at least in Legacy, in most decks. Someone asked earlier, and I explained that, like, if you have Uro in this deck with four cards in your graveyard, you can, like, Pyroblast or Hydroblast a random land to get the fifth card in the bin to rebuy it. Rough draw. That's helpful. Expressive Enduro. Ending being able to be rebought with Mystic. Yeah, that's a good point too. Hey, thanks, Coco. Hell yeah, IP in pools. Mono hamster control over here. I saw someone that said a plague engineer on hamster. Someone posted about it on Twitter. That's good. The dawn of a new age. Age of man is over. The age of the hamster has come. Being here without a reb, embarrassing. Fucking embarrassing. This makes my Uro a lot worse, huh? I think aggressively loaming when you don't need the land drops at all is pretty loose. Like, we'll get cards in the bin for Uro just by fucking drawing cantrips and casting spells. We don't need to spend draw steps doing that. I need one more island, right? Yeah. Man break Battle of Wits. Last time I played Battle of Wits in Legacy, it was strictly bug. I'm sure I'd be playing it with red now, though. Or expressive, Pyroblast, Hamster Dude. Resolves, huh? Interesting. Wonder what their hand looks like if that Minsk is landing. And they didn't endurance me there. Sweet. Chugging along. Alright, I need some water. For some reason, I didn't bring any of that. I'll be back in a few minutes. Hamster wins again! awesome. Let's play another match, why not? How are you all doing? How's your fucking... What's today? Saturday? Sunday? Today must be Saturday. Hey, Ray House, thanks for the $7.79. Ray says, hey, I just went 10-0 in my regional qualifier using your mono red creativity deck. Thanks a lot. Here's your cut. Thanks for the donation, Ray House. It wasn't my mono red creativity deck. I mean, I just net decked it, but yeah, I suppose you saw it here. Watch me play a few games with it. Good shit. Congratulations on the 10-0. That's awesome. This is, somebody's talking about the mono red creativity list, though. Cleaning up a brisket. Love it, Big Oofta. Nice. And thanks for confirming that today is Saturday. Hey, Sapatashi. I hope everyone's having a good one. Oh, it was my list because you were playing the main deck Ley Lines. Nice, Ray House. Oh, that's so much filthier. That's so much filthier. I love it. Oh, I'm so glad they were good for you. That makes me so happy. If we had a brainstorm inside one of these ponders, I would keep that Terminus. This makes Legacy look fun. In the first round, all we did was like pyroblast each other back and forth until one person was dead. I don't know. I love Legacy. I might not be high on this current format. Like, I'm winning, so that's fun, but it's a little dumb. it's a little dumb. Oh, fun. Dex! Not even a legend, I can't even bounce it. You like the Terminus sees some play outside top? Yeah, you can still set it up with Brainstorm. And it's still sometimes like a variant sweeper. But, yeah, much, much less play without top, huh? Much, much less play. And it's mostly a few specific streamers and players that are still into it. Great. Sylvan Library just like double covered here. How much money does it take to get a decent card collection for Magic? It's gonna depend. It's really gonna depend on what you're looking to do. It's like anything, right? Like you can dip your toe in or you can go full kit and caboodle. Like, if you ask, like, a random casual golf player what it costs for a reasonable set of clubs, you're gonna get a very different answer than if you ask, like, a pro golfer, right? I have a hard question to answer straight up. Yeah, if you want to play EDH, it's like any number. And then you can play Arena as a free-to-play, or if you want to try out constructed formats, you can use Magic Online with like a rental service. Like Mana Traders, who sponsors this stream. There's a link to them in the stream description. But yeah, in general, it's more a matter of like how much you got. It's not how much does magic cost, it's how much do you got. Crocus is also dumb. Here, now I've got a 4-5. Oh, they're swordsing! They're swordsing! That resolves! No take backsies! No take backsies! Yes! We were just playing to our outs! Force people probably should have pitched Force, huh? Oh my god. It's so close! We're so close to stabilizing! I think I have to shuffle, huh? I don't know if there's anything I can actually get off of a Ponder. Might be part of the issue with this plan. Is it a filter, or did I shave my beard? It's whatever you want. It's whatever you want to think. You're just dreaming. You're just dreaming, friend. Leaving one Pyroblast for their Yorion. That's a little bit better. Fewer dead cards, huh? Still not great. But certainly better. Staticaster is great versus Death and Taxes. It's one of the reasons it's in there, huh? I'd also bring it in against Elves. Why is main deck so many cards? Main deck is so many cards because Yorion rewards you for playing 20 more than the regular. You thought I was leaving one? Yeah, I was joking about that Slumpy Dumpty. It wasn't a serious. I'm not actually leaving a Pyroblast in. Good evening, Johan. I'm really enjoying this album. I hope, I even pre-ordered the another couple. King Gizzard is coming out with 3 more albums next month. I pre-ordered a couple of them. Hoping they rule. Hoping they kick ass. Kind of like getting a Valk down in case you want to express it next turn. I should probably get a sword for a white source for swords, huh? Oh, let's do the Valk thing. Oh no, this is wrong. It should be white for swords. In case they play spirit, then I can swords on upkeep. That would have been better. Nice. Didn't get blown out. So them passing here, I think, means that they've got the flash creature, so I'm just gonna pass back rather than run out Narset. Play Magus. I don't think there's much I can do about that. Like, if I don't Staticaster the Mom here, then they get to, Magus with protection, and I can't really beat that anyway. Exactly, Mr. Burrito. So it's not a bad turn to Expressive. I don't think it's a bad turn to Minskin Boo either. Just like Minskin Boo, make a 4-4 and pass. We should probably be keeping up swords though if we can. I'll just Expressive. I wonder if it's like overthinking things to not play the Sylvan, to just like pass and leave it in exile. The thing is, like, Vile on 3 can, they can recruit her for Magus, so that, like, this is the turn that they're most likely to have it to lock me out, is all I'm thinking about for leaving up swords. But that might just be cowardice, that might just be living in fear. I'm gonna pass, but I'm not super sure about it. The loss of Sylvan Library isn't that big of a deal with us at 13, too. They're gonna get some attacks in, probably. Correct, Chimfunks. That exact list. Well, I added one Force Negation, but otherwise, that exact list. Feels so weird to be sanctuarying back swords instead of Expressive. They win, right? Alright, GG. Well met. Good beats. And I could have just, like, kept on holding up swords, I guess. But I think they only play, like, a few Magus, right? And they usually have to tutor for it. And then they didn't do anything on their turn. So I thought we were good. Thought we were good to, like, just keep it up. Get the Minskin Boo down, still leaving Tundra up. Didn't live in enough fear? Maybe. We could have lived in more fear, or like maybe Minskin Boo prevents that. Because it can sack a creature to dome something. So if you just slam Minskin Boo there, because you're not living in fear, then you have a 4-4 hamster and you just pass the turn. And then if they play the Magus, you can just go like minus 2, hit that, or at least you like make them deal with this before the Magus lock you. Or, yes, I could have lived in even more fear. Played around not just Recruiter for Magus, but Magus naturally in hand. And that would have been fine, too. You forgot how soft we are to Blood Moon? Yeah. Yeah, this stream doesn't beat Blood Moon very often. Beard. Yeah, one of the sponsors of the stream will occasionally imbibe alcohol and throw money around. their first comment came with an $800 donation and a your mother joke, which, hilarious. Like, a your mother joke by itself, not hilarious. But if you're donating $800 to make a your mom joke, that's commitment. That's commitment to the bit. It starts to become respectable. And then the second donation came with $1,000 and was like, shave the beard, more to come. And I was like, all right. And so I shaved the beard in the middle of my match, like still playing Magic, you know, making moves. I don't want to like make my opponent wait, right? And then we were blessed. We were blessed with another $5,000 donation and 100 gift subs after that. So it was quite the night. Quite the night for Caleb. I'm swinging on a Mountain Dew energy drink right now. Recovering a little bit from the evening. I can actually shuffle away a brainstorm here. Possible keeping forces wrong. Hey, thanks, Hidology. I appreciate it. Hey, GLick55, thanks for 32 months. Thanks for sharing that Prime! Is this Mountain Dew mixed with anything? Nope, it's just Mountain Dew energy drink. Baja Blast. It is okay. Yeah, that was Mana Traders, Squalearm. Mana Traders has these fits of generosity. And I've seen them do it with other Magic streams that they sponsor too. Not just me. I kinda hate this endurance. It's kinda poops. Poop-durance. Yeah, big props to Mana Traders. Cool. I kind of want to put back the Force of Will. Yeah, let's do that, actually. Hell yeah, we drew. That's insane. Super cool. Thinking about the Taiga. I don't know all of his business dealings, Schwab. I know that he puts a lot of effort into mana traders, and I know that he went into mana traders as a business with a lot of backing capital. So I don't know his history. That's just like stuff that I can tell you from interacting with him. Seems pretty obvious. Should we actually put a Pyroblast on top of our library before downticking Narset? I don't think so. What I really want is an Expressive. Force Pitch Day's Undoing. I believe it is Hamster time. Like the thing yelling its clobber in time, but for hamsters. Yeah, Hamster time. Not everybody has a giant space hamster on their side. Whoa! Nice Narset, friend. Mind if I chuck a hamster at it? Hamster. I have not heard of it, Ectomaniac. That sounds sweet. Probably not a Terminus matchup, We might want some number of swords for the fucking Flash. The Flash Narset, the obnoxious one. We didn't see red mana out of them. They've gotta be playing Rebs, right? But they probably don't have Expressive. They probably just have some sideboard Rebs and a couple Valks in there somewhere. I think we could cut Endurance. I think Endurance might be worse than Forces in this matchup. I don't think they're using their graveyard at all. And then it's whether I want to random ass Hydro Blast, just in case.
Oh shit, what up?
Spell Pierce? Yeah. I think Spell Pierce might be good now, too. Bold running, unironically running like 4 of a 4-mana walker. I have to manually post them after the stream, Power Familiar. It's a pain in the dick.
Oh shit, what up?
But the Stream Decker app will have the deck list. If you want to check it out there, just use the deck command. Yeah, good evening, Lozric. Thanks for the 13 months there. In physics, thanks for the 39 months. Did I do something new with my hair? Yeah. Thanks for noticing. I always love to play swords. I could throw a random dress down in. Is endurance okay-ish? You could play one. The issue with endurance as opposed to Uro is that, like, you kind of have to fetch weirdly to play it early. Don't love it. Slow for a King Gizzard track. I'm gonna put on LW. I know we played it the other day, but I like this album a lot. Oh no, I wanted KG, not LW. Just kidding. Completely different album. I listened to this album so much. The first, like, two notes happened in the other album. I was like, oh no, this is the wrong one. Just kidding. You can brainstorm here, but, like, what are you brainstorming for, right? We kind of have everything we need. The opponent's not really doing much. I can just chill. Just keep vibing. Sure. Is this a brew? Nope. Not really. This took down a tournament over the weekend. It's an Anzid list, Anzid control list. I finally got some Minskin booze, so I'm trying it out. People have also just, like, thrown this deck into Delver and stuff, or this card into Delver and stuff. Showing up. Oh, you can play that Titania deck. That red-green thing. You can do that later. That might be more fun than Mono Black Aggro. Should I retitle the stream? I shall ponder. Yeah, Applejacks. That deck's fun. I think the last time I played it, I was splashing black for some discard. I think I deleted my old deck list, though. Wasteland for the Colossus on Uro, and then I'd have, like, a slightly better land in play, just in case we had to get into a counter battle with Brainstorm or something. Totally fine. Yeah, we play four Uros for a reason. I, like, never get into counter battles over it. This one I might get into counter battle over. Still got card advantage, huh? Off the Euro. Super organism, 'cause this is a kind of associate Titania as a Caleb card. Nice. I like that. I'm gonna rebuy that Reb, just have a better chance of resolving the Minskin Boo here. This is the format. This is just the fucking format. Reb your beb. This is what Vintage was like when I first played Vintage, way back in the day. Everyone main decking a pile of blasts. Kind of wild that that's where Legacy is now. The blue cards are too good! Minus the hamsters. The hamsters are new, that's valid. When are the other colors getting elemental blasts? That's what I want to know. Earlier I was joking that they should all counter blue cards. Keep it even. I care about any of this. Oh, I do. There's a Beb in there. Well. No, my card's not resolving, but I wanted it to resolve. I fucking knew it. I fucking knew they'd have some. Alright. My hamster. That's all right. We got more. I'll ponder a brainstorm here. I want one of them. At least we got a fucking hamster out of the deal, huh? How's Legacy going? It's going really well so far. Ooh. Don't mind if I do. Let's serve first. Are they making a shark? Are they making a shark to trade? Oh, they were originally going to make a 3-3 shark, but double blocking still trades with a hamster, and this way they can keep a mountain up to rep a Reb. Just slightly better tapping. My hamster! A giant shark! A shark fell from the skies and ate my magnificent hamster now! We get a point to trample this way, though. Yeah, take that, opponent. Over the eyes, boom! Yeah, yeah, Go for the Eyes was a voice line. I can't remember if it was the first one or the second one. I replayed them semi-recently, but even that was like some years ago now. These are tempting to pair with one another. Fill my deck up with trash. I want people to hold up Reb, getting Euro back here. Just not enough red sources in the deck. I'm actually gonna exile the Loam, so I don't have to deal with it on future turns. I should love that for me. God, I'm so fucking smart. Storm count 5. Oh, here we go. Two sanctuaries. Am I a madman? I mean, in these control mirrors, having your fetches be able to rebuy expressive iteration is really good. It's like super good. I guess. Not in love with this force. I think 2 is perfectly fine in a 60 card deck to boom. In a 60 card deck, though, you would want more of your cards to be islands. Like, you wouldn't play a Taiga and the Savannah that are in here. Or at least not both of them, right? No, the sanctuaries are great. If you draw them early, you just brainstorm away or hold on to them. Took me a little bit to be a believer on them. Will they just rebuy? I should have been paying attention. Put his swords on top. Okay. They are going to get to swords our Uro. I guess we can rev our own Uro. Actually, this could let me sack the Uro, right? We can attack them for 6. I mean, I guess we could just attack them for 10. I'm like thinking about how do I beat this swords to plowshares on top of their life. I literally have lethal here with counterspell protection. I'm like, how do I win? What do I do? What's my plan? What am I supposed to do here? Oh, they're at 7. Okay, that's boring. Yeah, I didn't think about Minsk and Boo sacking Uro. That's hilarious. That's like quite good, huh? One day I'll see the lines. Yeah, one day. One day. There's a reason Sanctuary is banned in Modern. Yeah, right? I agree with you, Madman. There's a big reason. So it's kind of an obnoxious fucking card. It's like one of my least favorite cards they've ever printed. Probably makes my top 20 list there. I don't love this opener. It's hard to love an opener with Terminus in it, but I don't think it's a mull either. If you ship this hand back and you get the same hand without a Terminus, it's like an easy keep, right? Which card? We're talking about Mystic Sanctuary. Excuse me. Some gas on top of the old library there. This is King Gizzard, yep, you are correct, CW. Really sure what's going on over on the opponent's end of things, but I guess we're about to find out with this discard. Just mana screwed. Just straight up screwed. Okay. Stubborn Denial? The fuck's playing Stubborn Denial? Maybe it's just like an interesting inclusion in the Murktide list. Maybe they're playing Grixis. Stifle, sure. With them discarding, it's possible I just shouldn't be playing cards. Because now if they went to discard again, you know, just like every turn. Card advantage for me. Instead of putting the land to hand, I could have put the Prismatic. I think would have been better, and then I run out the Delta and rebuy Expressive. Just have infinite gas. Looks like this was good enough, though. Am I subbing for Caleb tonight? I am Caleb! Always have been, ever since I was produced from a cloning vat yesterday. Yeah, I won't go into the process of that, but it's pretty gross. That's pretty gross. A lot of mucus involved. Oh, I suppose I want all these cards. We didn't see a red source for Hydro Blast. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna leave in all my removal shit. You imagine it's similar to Neo leaving the Matrix? It's similar, for sure. For sure. I would say, if anything, it's grosser, though. And the, but there's not, like, a lot of little tubes. It's just, like, one big one that brings you your food and removes your poop at the same time somehow. It becomes, like, one mixture. And anyway, I said I wasn't going to get into the details. I shouldn't be getting into the details. You're just going to have, like, more questions afterwards, right? One question leads to the next. Also, something the Matrix got wrong is just, like, how gross the sounds of it all are coming out. Way grosser than you'd assume. Oh, I love that, someone don't know come. I might have been born yesterday, but I stayed up all night. Love it. MBA stands for Mono Black Aggro, and I might do another Minskin Budak instead, but I do have Mono Black Aggro prepped. I can take that out of the stream title. Minskin Boo action. That's the real NBA. How do you tell the difference between the clone and the original? Oh, with Caleb's? Well, the new clone comes out when the original... There hasn't been an original in a while. We'll just put it that way. It's not an issue. It doesn't come up. Yeah. Probably a little too dark. A little too dark for the stream. I kind of hate this opener against Grace's Death Shadow. No one-man interaction. Ooh, there we go. Somehow Caleb returned. Wow, spoilers, Ordinary Joe. Some people haven't seen that movie. In fact, a lot of people haven't seen that movie. It's great. If any of y'all haven't seen Moon, you should go watch it. Not now, because you're watching me, and I'm pretty important. But, like, it's a really good movie. Perhaps Sam Rockwell's best performance, and he's put out a ton of good performances. Kind of like spoiling the Sixth Sense workshops or fucking The Usual Suspects. Like, yeah, the movie's been out for a while, but like, if you want someone to watch the fucking thing. Suspects is your partner's favorite movie. Do they rewatch it? It seems like such an odd one. It's good, but it's a movie that I have no desire to rewatch. Yeah. This is kind of what I was worried about with the opener. No cantrips to keep the flow of lands going. I'm actually playing the Sanctuary. I hate playing the Sanctuary out. It seems like a thing to do here, though. Right, workshops, exactly. It's not like a Snape kills Dumbledore type situation. Just because Moon's like kind of uncommon. And it's super fucking good. Ooh, hello. No, I'm getting stifled and then I'm gonna lose. Cause stifle's mean. You're mean. Should I scoop? I'm not gonna scoop. I wanna scoop though! Fucking bullshit. Okay. Thanks for that, Master Mike. Maybe I'll give it another watch. Chat was saying this was Grix's death shadow. Ha! Chat doesn't know shit. Alright, now I'll scoop. I actually want another Force of Will if they're stifling. Want those free counters. Can we get a shout out to Alan Rickman? We can. Fucking love Alan Rickman. Shout out to Alan Rickman, I guess. Any of you unfamiliar with this Alan Rickman character? Did some good work. Didn't get started in his acting career until very late, right? Like, wasn't he in his 40s or whatever when he was discovered? My favorite Alan Rickman movie, and this will probably surprise some of you, is actually Perfume, a story of a murderer, where he plays the antagonist. The protagonist has, like, this super weird sense of smell, and he's trying to, like, make a perfume from like, dead redheads' bodies or something. I'm not going to go too deep into that, but it's a very artsy movie, it's very pretty, and Alan Rickman plays the antagonist who is trying to protect his daughter from getting stolen and made into perfume, and he does a really good job in that role. It's good. It sounds like a horror movie, but it's not really. It's a... I did take a redhead to that for a first date, yeah. And it was right when there was like a middle of a dead redhead montage that I looked over and realized. She thought it was hilarious though. Caleb trolling the chat? Nope. Not trolling the chat, Vivid Gray. That's the movie. It's also got Dustin Hoffman. Dustin Hoffman does a really good job in that movie, too. He usually does, but he's enjoyable. Wow, chat making some creepy jokes. Good times. We fetch now, we can't get stifled. But if they had a stifle, wouldn't they lead on a blue land? I also don't want to get wastelanded, is the tension. Does sound like King Gizzard. It is King Gizzard. Yeah, but there's a difference about me talking about a creepy movie and then, like, people making creepy jokes about one of my exes who was awesome. Yeah, she ruled. Making jokes about fictional characters, a little different than joking about being a creep to an actual person, right? Can we agree that there's a difference there? I know that I just seem like a person on the television to you. I know I don't seem like a real person because I'm not sitting in a room with you, but I am. I am, actually. Galaxy Quest is up there, Thrifted Mitch. I do love me some Galaxy Quest. That movie fucking rules. We have to express it for land drops here. I'd like to get the Narset down. Oh, here we go. Can I actually just do both? Now we won't be getting the Narset down, but I think it's worth. Because they only have two islands over there. Those are your top five Alan Rickman movies? That doesn't make sense. I did not have a funeral for my beard, no. That would have made sense, though. Carpet of Flowers is pretty good. If you have stuff to do with the mana, it's very good. If you don't have stuff to do with the mana, it's trash, but... It feels like this deck always has stuff to do with the mana, right? Just infinite gas for the expressives and everything, and the Euros, and even Yorion. Uh-oh. Should I fetch here? I think I should. We've been to Hydro Blast the other turn. Get it back into the deck. so we could still Narset and look for Hydro Blast, but I think we want to bring the Eurobank. The issue with Uro here is it doesn't beat the Minsk and Boo. Play next turn, they can make it a 7-7, right? That's awesome, though.
Oh, shit. What up?
Wow, I didn't realize that Minsk and Boo just, like, makes Caracas better. Yeah, one more card. Oh, they play Stifle. I should fetch now. Wow, get rocked. Is Caracas gonna see even more play now? This card just answers this whole fucking Planeswalker. Only that expressive for the last Sanctuary to rebuy. The game has ended! Yeah, this deck seems like fucking impossible to play against for a fair blue mirror. The matchup we lost to is like Stock Death and Taxes, where we're main decking all these like Pyroblasts and, and Narsets and shit. Fucking none of our win conditions can beat a Caracas. We lost to the quad Caracas deck. That didn't even come up either. We just got dumpstered by Hate Bears.